Plastic behavior in steel has been used for a very long time. A typical traditional profession using plastic properties is the blacksmith. Here you can see an example. It's a knot. In steel constructs, doubly symmetrical I sections are the most commonly used type of cross section. For the design of stocky steel cross sections, the elastic theory or the plastic theory can be applied. Using the plastic bearing capacity, the classification in class 1 or 2 is required. That means that a certain width to thickness ratio is necessary. For typical I sections, the plastic load-bearing capacity for a single internal moment is up to 59% higher compared to the elastic load-bearing capacity. Because of economic reasons, the plastic bearing capacity is preferred. In plastic design, an individual interaction condition is required. Focus of this study is the research of plastic bearing capacity considering the two bending moments and the warping moment and the evaluation of the accuracies of current and known results. Depending on the load, the static system, the cross-section and the determination theory, different internal forces and moments can occur. In this example, two bending moments occur according to first-order theory. In literature and standards, different interaction conditions for two bending moments are specified. Except for PIM+, the deviations for these interactions are unknown. A total of 114 cross-sections of the IPE, HEAA, HEA, HEB and HEM PROFI series were analyzed. For each cross-section, the load-bearing capacity of 21 combinations of internal forces and moments was determined. This leads to 2,394 analyses for each interaction condition. The deviations were determined comparing interaction condition to numerical results from the program Lillebeck. Note that all available internal forces and moments are taken into account. PIM Plus leads to the best results, but the interaction condition is not that simple. Using easy-to-use solutions according to 18800 or Eurocode 3 Part 1.1 occur quite inaccurate results. The interaction condition according to Eurocode 3 Part 1.1 leads to uneconomical results and the solution according to 18800 Part 1 is partly non-conservative. Comparing the interaction conditions according to standards to numerical results leads to different scatterings. The factor is compared to the linear interaction. For this reason, most factors are located above 1. The intention of this research is to develop a practical and economical interaction condition. The solution should be easy to apply. For this reason, the extended exponent method is developed. Using regression studies and an extensive number of variants, the interaction condition with a modified exponent can be determined. The interaction condition takes the web component into account. Compared to standards, the extended exponent method leads to results with the lowest scattering and the lowest deviation. The extended exponent method represents a sufficiently economical and simple solution. For a calculation according to the second order theory, including an equivalent bow imperfection, two bending moments and a warping moment will regularly occur. So, three internal forces and moments have to be taken into account within the interaction condition. An interaction condition considering warping moment is not available in Eurocode 3 part 1.1. A possible approach could be the alternative lateral torsional buckling analysis according to Eurocode 3 part 6. In addition, this analysis is modified by Kuhlmann. Originally, these verification methods were developed for stability analysis. The influence factors due to stability can't be excluded. In literature, also some other interaction conditions are available. For each of the 114 cross-sections, 229 combinations were analyzed. This leads to 26,106 analyses for each interaction condition. Using the interaction condition according to Eurocode 3 part 6, the ratio of the warping moment has to be limited to 0.3. Otherwise, it occurs non-conservative results. PIM plus leads to the best results, but the interaction condition is very complex. Most of the interaction conditions lead to very uneconomical results. In addition, the solutions of Kuhlmann and Lindner lead to large scatterings. Analogous to the previous section, a solution using the extended exponent method is presented. In case that an internal force and moment is equal to zero, the interaction condition presented in the previous section can be concluded. Compared to the solutions of Kuhlmann and Lindner, the extended exponent method leads to results with the lowest scattering and the lowest deviation. To sum up, for the verification of the plastic load-bearing capacity, for each cross-section type, an individual interaction condition is required. In addition to bending around the strong axis, also bending around the weak axis and the warping moment have to be considered, verifying the plastic load-bearing capacity. In Eurocode 3 part 1.1, no interaction condition is available taking two bending moments and a warping moment into account. For this reason, different interaction conditions from literature and current research projects were analyzed in this study. In general, most of the analyzed interaction conditions lead to conservative but uneconomical results. The presented extended exponent method is characterized by a very simple handling and leads to fine economical and conservative results. The extended exponent method yields more accurate results than other simplified solutions.